welcome back to the Victor China Open. Here we're getting ready for our players for the second match on the TV court to be introduced. It's going to be a women's doubles affair. See four courts in operation across this venue. And up next, as you see, Fukuman and Yonao against Tang Jinhua and Yu Shouhan. That's how that fits into the draw. Number three seeds potentially await in the second round, but we might just be getting a little bit ahead of ourselves there. Players are out on court, you can see. First ever meeting. Give you some details momentarily on these players. Noku Fukuman from Japan, World Championship bronze in the women's doubles in Jakarta 3 years ago. You see that ranking 15, they have been up at number 7 before. That was in January. And her partner, Kurumi Yonao, been together for 7 years, these two. They've won 6 titles together, most recently they won an event in Osaka this year. It's actually their first win for some 4 seasons. The doubles pair. Tang Jinhua won a couple of Uber Cup women's team titles, 20 women's doubles titles in her career with various partners, not all with Xiaohan, ranking at 29. Well, at number one, it's 4 years ago, number one in the world. There's Yu, won the US Open earlier this year in California, these two. That was their first title as a pair. Taylor in the chair from Australia. Sun Gang from China is the service judge. Just a precaution, that knee brace on Tang Jinhua's knee.
Judge, ladies and gentlemen. On my right, Miyako Fukuman, Kurumi Yano, Japan. And on my left, Tang Jinhua, Yu Xiaoshen, China. Yu Xiaoshen to serve to Miyako Fukuman. Love all. Play.
So China serving first. Sweep of Yu. And you fancy that if Tang and Yu are on anywhere near top form today, then Fukuman and Yonao are going to struggle. Despite the fact that both of those Japanese players are pretty experienced campaigners. And they're on the board in the opening game. From the back of the court from YONAO. Confident lead and a correct one at the back of the court from Xiaohan. Well, they're off to a flyer here. Didn't say I kind of had a fear for the Japanese pair if Tang and Yu were anywhere close to their best. That's the way it's proved so far. Nice change of angle. Well, terrific rally, and the Chinese come out on top again, and you can hear what the crowd think about it. Got the end tip of Yonao's racket. Longest and best rally of the match. When they miss. Time. Yes, after her, and either of the Japanese FUKUMAN will run out. So they'll go for the interval after a very rapid first half of the first game. 11-3. Fruitless. Quite as easy as it looked when you're on the run like that. Very easy to pull your arm down and put that in the net, but that was exemplary. They can win the beautiful points, if you like. Can win the ugly ones, too. Swung up fresh air. You're now. And they're running away with this. 14-4 now. So Tang and Yu. Surprise when they miss a shot. They've started. Japanese need a little run of points. 7-15. Murmurings in the crowd, they obviously are somewhat partisan. Their pairing has just gone off the boil a little bit. this level, there's going to be too much encouragement.
Service over. 16-8.
Recovery stopped in its tracks, however. Very, very solid at the net, you.
17-9.
Doesn't miss very often at all. Nothing that you now could do. Just on top, we're getting the breaks as well after that. Net cord. Got them into double figures, but still in a world of trouble here in this opening game. Away now then. They've just been dominant from the back of the court at the net. Watching no errors. So closing in then on the screen here, unless there's some quite dramatic turnaround. Likely now, as they move to nine game points in this opening game. All about the timing in the back of the court from you. Don't try and hit it too hard. Talk about holding your nerve, just about the longest rally of the match, but it was the Japanese who blinked first. 21-11, they take the opening game.
Thank you.
So just 14 minutes for that opening game. Tang and Yu.
Second game.
Be keen to finish the job here against FUKUMAN, YONAO pair that just haven't got going really at any stage. Maybe now. You serving. Well, great defense and then good judgment. I think they were just claiming it flicked off the racket, but
one love.
Umpire Susan Taylor, absolutely adamant. I can't ask Hawkeye for that. One of those in the whole of the first game. I think winning that US Open title I mentioned earlier in the year was a big confidence booster for this Chinese pair. Certainly as a pairing, and clearly Tang's got a phenomenal record.
Service over.
In doubles. Correct. Much point challenging that. I'm just looking to get a bit of advice from the coach there, not on the whether to appeal, just whether to challenge. Just see what she was saying. She
didn't, over. Three,
stay quiet ever, I don't think. Feel. There's someone's got it in for them.
Return.
I think what they were saying was it was a double hit, but which it was. Sat up and basically said, kill me. She did, unceremoniously. I think when you've, then they've questioned a couple of calls, the Japanese pair, when you start to get the mindset that the world's against you, it doesn't often prove your game. And all of a sudden, there's a bit of daylight. Scoreboard again.
Line judge. Please.
Just need to mop a little bit of the court here.
Oh.
You serving. Now their judgment's being affected.
You
can just see the frustration on the Japanese faces. Knew it was the wrong decision. Soon as it landed, going to play it, then left it. And then, oh, what have I done? Somewhat better judgment being showed by Tang and Yu. Ranked 29, but Tang was ranked number one 4 years ago.
Service over, 4-9.
Well, they finally stopped the rot, but I just wonder whether it might not be too late. A really good angle, really clever
Service
shot.
Over 10-4.
Didn't see it coming. It's just that air of resignation on the two Japanese players' faces, and that comes from just the scoreboard pressure and also thinking that, you know, there's no justice in the world. Surprising miss from
Tang.
Defense. Really good credit there. FUKUMAN, YONAO. But odds on to lose the point. A good leave, and that's
Service
the halfway point.
11-6.
So we'll go to the interval, 11-6. Tang and Yu have the advantage. Wouldn't have been worth challenging that. And they have to produce something a bit special now. So the point of no return, really, as far as FUKUMAN and YONAO are concerned.
11-6.
be entertaining rally. The problem, as far as the Japanese pair are concerned, is just don't seem to win very many of those points after, you know, 40-50 shot exchange. Always seem to know just a bit too much for them. That's the way it feels. Just has had a creeping air of inevitability about it for some while. Almost fighting over who was going to play the backhand smash there. Either one could actually.
Out. Service over.
Just be a little bit of complacency creeping in there.
14.
Service error. First, we should probably forgive them for that. 14-8 up, one game up. Cool. Oh, it was almost smashing practice, wasn't it? Almost alternate Tang and Yu moved to win 5 points, to within 5 points of securing the match. Ranking at 29 is obviously only going to get better. Tang's actually won 20 titles in women's doubles in her career with various different partners.
17-10.
It was you though who finished that off. And now the Japanese pair in deep trouble. Excellent shot again from Tang.
10. Oh. 19-10.
Just want to get out of the arena now, to be honest. Been pretty one-sided, to be fair. Hey. There have been some entertaining rallies, but invariably it's been the Chinese who've come out on top. And after just over half an hour on court, 10 match points to Tang and Yu. That'll do it. 21-11, 21-10. As I say, in just over half an hour. And they might take some stopping in the women's doubles this week. Most impressive.
Match won by Feng Yuan, Yu Xiaohan, 21-11, 21-10.